Today I'll be showing you guys how to install the Ice and Fire mod for Minecraft version 1.16.4. And this tutorial is pretty much the same for any version of Minecraft that you're installing it for. So in the future when Minecraft 1.17 comes out and this mod gets updated for Minecraft 1.17, the installation process will pretty much remain the same and this video is still useful. So if you guys didn't know, this Ice and Fire mod adds rideable, tameable dragons into your Minecraft game, and I did a mod showcase of it last week, so you guys can go ahead and check that out if you haven't already done so. Link is down in the video description. Now you guys are going to want to follow this tutorial pretty closely and watch it till the end so that you don't miss out on any steps, because this is kind of a complicated mod to install. But before we get into it guys, don't forget to drop a like on the video and consider subscribing. I upload Minecraft videos here on my channel on a regular basis. Alright, so first of the two prerequisites that you need is Minecraft Forge. So you want to head over to files.minecraftforge.net, link is also in the video description down below. You want to select the version that you're downloading Forge for, which in my case it is 1.16.4. Then you want to click download recommended and make sure you select installer. So click that. So once you wait a couple of seconds, click skip and it should start downloading here as you can see. And you want to keep the jar file and you want to click it. And it should actually launch this launcher as you can see. And what you want to do is you want to click install client and hit OK. So you click install client, hit OK, give it a couple of seconds and it will install Forge. So again, give it some time. Successfully installed client profile Forge for version 1.16.4. So once it says this, you are pretty much done for Minecraft Forge. Okay, once you've installed Minecraft Forge, the next thing you need to install before you can actually install the Ice and Fire Dragon mod itself is Citadel. As you can see on the Ice and Fire Dragons mod page, it says that this mod requires Citadel 1.4.0 or newer. So again, link to Citadel is in the video description down below. So clicking that link, it'll take you to this page. What you want to do is you want to click on Files and you want to select the version of Citadel that corresponds to the correct Minecraft version. In my case, it's 1.16.4, Citadel 1.16.4. So I'm just gonna click download here and give it a couple of seconds and it should start. And then you wanna keep the jar file, and this one, you wanna launch your Windows Explorer. You wanna type %@data%. So once you have arrived at your .minecraft page, there should be a mods folder. Now, if you guys have never installed a single Minecraft mod before, the folder won't actually be there. So what you can do is you can right click, click new folder and just name it mods like so, all lowercase, and it should still work. So double click on the mods folder and you wanna drag in Citadel into your mods folder and then you are basically done. And you don't wanna close this window yet because there is one more thing you need to install, which is the Ice and Fire Dragon mod itself, of course. So click on Files, and then you want to select the version. In this case, it's 1.16.4 Ice and Fire mod. And you can just click here to let the download start. Once it's downloaded, you want to, as usual, drag this in into your mods folder, and there you have it. So make sure you have installed everything else first. Make sure you have installed Minecraft Forge, Citadel, and last but not least, we have the Ice and Fire mod itself. So once you have installed all these three, you are ready to start your Minecraft game. So just click, double click on your Minecraft launcher and you want to select the Forge profile that you've installed here and you want to click play and you want to tick that you understand the risk of using Minecraft mods. So how to know that you've installed the Ice and Fire mod correctly is that firstly, the title screen you can see is completely different. There are dragons in the background and stuff like that. And at the bottom left-hand corner, it says Ice and Fire as well. So I've launched my single player world. And as you can see, if I click spawn, there's a lot of these new mobs. That means that you have installed the Ice and Fire mod correctly. And if you guys have any questions, let me know in the comment section down below and I'll respond to you guys as soon as I can. And don't forget to like and subscribe as well. Check out the Ice and Fire mod showcase that I did about a week ago. It's on my channel and the link is in the video description as well. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.